Hiya, Martin here at Martin's Bazaar. Thanks for joining me again this week. This week we've got a bit of a mammoth project coming up. I was recently voted onto Facebook's Arts and Crafts Emporium, which is a group of artisans that come together and they exhibit and sell their wares once a month in a theme that's given to them. And this month is Myths and Legends. You can hop over to their Facebook page. I'll put the link below. You can hop over there to their page on Facebook, have a good look round at the previous themes and stuff that they've done. And also, if you go over on the 7th of December, you'll be able to see everything that's been put into the exhibition and the sale for Myths and Legends. And this is my what I'm putting in. This is the Flight of Icarus. Very symbolic, because I'm not an artist as such in the traditional sense. I can't paint or draw for toffee. So here is the Flight of Icarus. It is sapele wood, about 12 inches, 11 inches in diameter, 2 inches thick, with a symbol of Icarus's arm with his feathers and wax, with the sun in the middle, and then up here we have the Greek spelling of Icarus. It's been gold gilted, as you can see, but anyway, you'll see everything in the video. So this is how I made the Flight of Icarus.
Right, here we are in front of the computer. I've got Adobe Illustrator up on screen at the moment, as to design for the bowl. I need to get it onto the computer to print it off, so I can then transfer it onto the bowl. The other night I was thinking about what I was going to do for the Arts and Crafts Emporium Myths and Legends theme for December. And I thought, oh, I know, I quite fancy the Flight of Icarus, amongst various other things. And on the back of an invoice over dinner, I came up with this. It's a little bit rough at the moment, obviously, because it's just a sketch on the back of an invoice. But what we have is a bit of a wing stroke arm design with all the feathers and stuff, with a central sun. It's all very symbolic. I like to do things much more symbolically rather than literally, for want of a better word. And then the Greek spelling of Icarus up here. I need to design this and get it out onto paper. But what I want to do is create a nice design that I can transfer over. So all I'm going to do is trace over the design I've already got and refine it a little. Now, the good thing about Adobe Illustrator is that it makes everything into vector. And there we have it. There is the final design for the wall hanging. It's not going to be a bowl, it's going to be a wall hanging. But for now, let's go out to the workshop and get making the wall hanging.
Out in the workshop, I have chosen the piece of wood that I'm going to make the Flight of Icarus wall hanging out of, and I've chosen this piece of sapele. It's a very similar piece of wood to the dish that I did that was inspired by runes with all the symbols around the outside. So we're going to get this up onto the lathe, but first of all I need to mark out the centre and then mount it on the lathe and start turning it.
Now that it's on the worm screw, with a full face shield and a respirator and a very sharp bowl gouge, I'm going to turn it round. Now it's round, I'm going to turn the tool rest round so it has to work on the bottom of the bowl. The main shaping of the bowl done, well the wall hanging done, and now I need to sand it. I'll sand it down to 400 grit and then I'll get the blowtorch on it.
A few seconds just to cool down, calm down. Spin and a rub down to 600 grit sandpaper, and that will bring back some of the natural colour of the wood. Danish oil next. I love using Danish oil. It's a lovely finish. Deepens the colour of the wood, highlights the grain. It's nice and light to apply. It dries quickly. Oh, great stuff. Again, as you can see, the piece is darker and the gold will be glinting, I should think. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Lovely. Before I rub in the gold gilt, I want to put three stripes around the outside. A thin one, a thick one, and then a thin one. So I'll use a thin parting tool and a diamond-shaped parting tool to make the stripes. Gold time. I use Liberon gilt cream. It's really rather good. It comes in a bit of an oily substance. Some on the blue roll. Lose my tool rest. And then rub it in. I think. Yeah, right now I've got to go around the edges and I want to get it into the stripe that I put up here. There's the gold gilt rubbed into the side of the piece. I don't know how well it comes out on the video, but it's there and it looks all nice and glinty, and there's a lovely shine on the piece already.
With the piece reversed in the tuck now, turned around. I've got to start off by making the top of the piece nice and true. So I'll be using a bowl gouge again, and then I can hollow out the inside.
The inside of the piece done now. I can now go ahead and sand it down to 400 grit, and then I can transfer my design onto it. Let's hope for the best. The next step, I've taken the bowl or the piece off the lathe, and I've got it over here on the workbench. Here it is. The inside is kind of half done, and the back is virtually finished. Now I've also printed off the design that I'm going to put onto onto the bowl, or onto the piece. But I need to cut it out first, so I can put the transfer paper underneath and get everything in the right places. Now, I don't think I need to be particularly accurate with this. I'm a bit more set up now. I've got the design over the top of the graphite paper, and the graphite paper is going right down onto the bowl. So now I just need to trace over the design, which will then transfer it onto the piece, and I've got the piece on a piece of non-slip mat as well. So. Finally, there we are. There's the name of Icarus on there, and the rest of the carving's done. Right, back onto the lathe and start sanding down. Again. I've had a slight change of plan. The design of the feathers here for his arm, I don't mind. I can't see them well enough, so I'm going to go back with the Dremel and I'm going to take off the surface of the wood like I did with Icarus up here, and then gold gilt that. Back on the lathe again, I've carved out the wings once more, or the wing, the feathers, whatever, and now I can rub the gold gilt directly into those, and with any luck, you'll be able to see them a little bit better, or a lot better, than first time round. There we go, it's nearly finished. The gold gilt's on, it's had a coat of lathe polish, and I need to leave it overnight now for the gilt to go hard, and then I can give it a buffing in the morning. Hello again, it's a cold and damp Monday morning. I'm out here in the workshop with a cup of coffee, my Icarus piece, and a new pot of gold gilt. The gilt that I put onto the Icarus piece on Saturday hasn't come out as I had wanted it to, or hoped it would do. It's just a little bit too dark, so I picked up a new pot of gold gilt that's brighter than the original, quite considerably brighter, I think you'll agree. This is the new one, that's the old one, so I'm going to go back over the piece with the new gold, and it will be a lot better. Once more with feeling, as they say, I'm using the same brush as I did last time, which is just a sort of a normal paintbrush. that I've trimmed the bristles down on to make it a bit stiffer. And then I'm just going to paint or layer the new gold, which already is looking a lot better. And the gilt is done, the brighter gilt is done on the piece. As you can see, it's much brighter. I'm much happier with it now. I've just got to leave it now for 24 hours and then I can get it back on the lathe and give it a good buffing again. Morning. Well, here we are again. I've put the gilt on, it's Tuesday morning, and we're ready to give the gilt on Icarus a bit of a buffing. Hopefully it's going to turn out okay today. We'll just have to see. So let's give it a buffing and see what it looks like. There we go, all finished. The flight of Icarus is done, thankfully. Right, don't forget to pop over to the Arts and Crafts Emporium on Facebook on the 7th of December, or even pop over there now and see what other people are doing, and don't forget to like their page. Thank you very much indeed for subscribing to me on YouTube and liking me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, etc, etc, etc. Thank you very much indeed, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the flight of Icarus. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.